2009, Bradley Groves takes over Spennymoor Town with a vision to drive the club forward and put Moors on the map. The revolution had begun. Eight years, four promotions, and 11 trophies later, Moors are now competing with household names in English football on a weekly basis. 2011, the club becomes only the third team in history to reach 100 points and seal the Northern League title. Yeah! 2012, under the leadership of Jason Ainsley, Moors lifted the Durham Challenge Cup for the first time in 15 years. 2013, arguably the biggest moment in the club's history. This man gave us the lead. After Tunbridge equalised, upset this man was to keep grading to send the Spennymoor fans in the rafters. The biggest day in the club's history had ended in victory. Moors had won the FA Vars.
I'm a proud man, and the players should be proud, and the support should be proud of the team as well.
It was unbelievable. You know, I've never seen so many people come to wish a team good luck and best wishes, but that was awesome, like, you know.
2015, Spennymoor Town were promoted to the Evo Stick Northern Premier League, the first time in their history.
Fantastic occasion, fantastic day for a club. You know, you just had to stand out here and come outside here at 3 o'clock to see the support that we had today.
2016, a historic moment in the club's history, with a glittering day in the sun at League One MK Dons, the first round of the FA Cup. In 2017, Spennymoor announced their arrival at their highest level in their history following victory over Stourbridge in the playoff final. The season began with an earth-shaking victory over ex-Football League giants Stockport County. Progression has been rapid, difficult, and relentless. Yeah. But it doesn't stop here. We rely on you for nights like this to keep our momentum going and continue to punch above our weight. We've improved the team, the ground, and the club as a whole. Help us keep moving forward. We've improved the team, the ground, and the club as a whole. Help us keep moving forward.
We asked for your help and you answered the call. Here we are in 2019 and Spennymoor are continuing to defy the odds on and off the pitch.
After missing out on the playoffs in the final minute of our maiden National League North campaign, we headed into the new season full of optimism. And what a season it turned out to be.
One thing about Spennymoor is, in every year that I've been here, they've always been fighting for something at the end of the season.
We are underway.
Despite a slow start, Moore's picked up momentum quickly and gained memorable wins over the likes of Hereford and York City. The win they brought more success, with a vital win at Chorley, followed by a 7-goal demolition of Alphington Tower. The new year brought new challenges and Moore's are well in the hunt for a playoff place in 2019, but it was in the FA Trophy where their best performance was delivered. Playoff ambitions soon turned to title talk as Moore's surged up the table with 7 straight wins. But a rough month in March saw Moore's eventually finish 4th, securing a playoff spot at York City before a 1-0 win over Chorley.
Burnish gets up, 1-0! To secure a place in the National League North playoffs. Yes! Good
turn! 6 teams, 5 games, 1 winner. The prize? Promotion to the National League. The playoffs were about to begin. One down, 2 to go. Moore's made the long trip to Brackley, looking to reach the playoff final. And what followed was a day that no one will ever forget.
It's finished here in extra time. Brackley Town 0, Spennymoor Town 0 in this Vanarama National League North playoff semi-final. And it's going to penalties here.
It was a mixed emotions, really. People were scared, people were excited. I was so nervous. I was like, I couldn't watch.
Yes! 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 Did I win a ball? And he's put it over the bar! See, this is it now,
scene was set here at Victory Park as Moors went head to head with Chorley for a place in the National League.
See the disappointment on their faces, you know, that's probably what made me crack a little bit, you know, because I'm an emotional person as it is, but I felt I kept it strong that on the pitch until I seen them lads in tears, you know, and it just shows you what it meant to the group. You know, we had some really disappointed players in that dressing room, but when you look back, I'm immensely proud. I think forgetting the football, I think the togetherness of the supporters has grew immensely throughout the season. So we've got that real togetherness, you know, and like I said, I can't be prouder of the club as a whole.
May have been heartbreaking the playoff final, but exciting times were ahead as the ground development began at the Brewery Field.
The process started a year ago where we filled in an awful lot of forms, planning permission, trying to get some grant funding from the Football Foundation, understanding what we wanted to do, negotiating with contractors. It started last October.
We've come a long way in 10 years. The pitch itself has been a task, shall we say the least. And over the summer, when we came in and it was getting done to begin with, the CLS team did a cracking job. But just to see it getting 2 inches skimmed off the top, to actually see the lay of the pitch and how unflat, if I can say that, it was. They had to go down further just to try and get all the turf off the top.
Main message was to have a top quality service. And to be honest, when the contractors come in, I was here to make sure they were doing their job as well. The right top soil and sand and fertilizers, stuff like that. So and after they've done their bit, I've had to make sure I give a good service to the players.
It was fascinating to see it on a daily basis. We watched for the first time as the sprinklers came on, I can't lie. It was a personal moment for me. I never ever thought we'd see that on that pitch. It's funny how a spray of water can stop everyone in their tracks and stand and watch it for 25 seconds before you snap out of it and move on to doing what you were doing.
All of the hard work in applying for grants, applying for planning permission, then it went. And when the pitch disappeared, it's kind of, wow, let's hope this works in time.
So again, once the drainage went in, the sprinklers went in, then I've just had to make sure the seed was going through the sprinklers and make sure I was putting the right fertilisers on, the right chemicals. So it's getting the right, it's all about right timing for a groundsman as well. It's just about getting the right chemicals at the right time. So, but at the minute, I'm over the moon with the pitch myself.
To where we are now is an absolute transformation from where this club was a year ago.
Fantastic 9 months on and off the pitch. came in January with a real clear focus in mind of putting in a strategy and a structure and a competency that would lay the foundation. So it might sound like a cliche, but you can build the best house in the world, but without the solid foundations, the house crumbles. Put a strategy and structure in place that considers the future for Spennymoor Town youth, not just the short term, but the next 5 years, the next 10 years, and putting community and football development at the core of everything we do. So we've got people, purpose and pride as our core values, and our people, our youngsters, our parents, our coaches, and that link with the local community is absolutely vital.
Andy coming in was always part of that becoming a full-time role. It had to become a full-time role as we go down the educational route. So we're looking at the young people of Spennymoor from the age of 2 all the way up to the age of 23. That's what we're looking to fulfil. Give them the best start in life, put an education programme in. Andy was the best fit for that, and he's done a remarkable job in a short space of time, building on the great work that Ryan and his team have done.
The infrastructure that's been built since we've changed, it's rapid, you know what I mean? We are moving in the right direction very quickly.
Dude, the academy is the setup really one of the best in the Northeast, and I'm really happy to be here to join the academy. We feel like a one family. And everybody here is very friendly. My kids is settled here really well.
Club could go for generations with this youth academy.
This club could go professional.
Yes.
I could go to the Premier League.
The standards are absolutely fantastic. If you come down on a nicer day and you stand at the top and you look down, you see all the kids training. It's very professional, but at the same time, the kids are actually enjoying themselves. You can see the smile on the faces.
Just going from my old academy where I was getting bullied to just coming to a place where I can feel like home. It's just a really nice place to come.
We have a real opportunity here in Spennymoor to make a huge difference in the community. With facilities, with module facilities, with changing rooms, with classrooms, with toilets, with showers, etc. It just opens so many doors to be able to embrace the community more. So holiday programmes, coaching programmes, disengagement programmes, working with the police and the local authorities. Having our own facility and modular buildings allows us to do that.
Facilities are the main stumbling block, really, to let us progress to that next level. Car park, and obviously that we haven't got. It's the toilets we haven't got, it's the changing rooms we haven't got, and in weather like this, we need a different kind of ground, don't we? You know, we need 3G, 4G type pitches to
shelter from the weather for the kids.
As you can see, there's quite a lot of children down here and parents, and if we have welfare facilities such as toilets, refreshments, I think it'll just actually add to how good the club and the academy is.
Fortunate a few weeks back to have the Lionesses here training, Phil Neville, the ladies. Women's football now is at the forefront of female sport. So we have an opportunity now to build, to grow, develop, not just boys' football, not just men's football, but girls and boys, girls and women's football as well.
If we didn't have football, we wouldn't be the people who we are today.
Spennymoor Town's story continues to gather momentum. A new stand, clubhouse, a new pitch. A men's team competing for promotion, a ladies' team on the rise, a thriving academy. Now is the time to be part of the journey. We are Spennymoor Town. We are the pride of County Durham.